No, God's a giver. God gives love. God extends love. God extends only love. And God doesn't even know what reciprocity is. So God's not saying, listen, I'll give to you, my beloved child. And now, here's the conditions. This is what I want back in return. Even when Christians, really well-meaning Christians sometimes will say, our God is a jealous God. You know, you've got all these distractions and God wants only your focus and attention. That's still a bit bizarre to say God is jealous. As if God is aware of all these distractions somehow. He's like, pay attention to me some too. You know, I created you, at least come. Pray to me some. And praise me. Come on, praise, come on. Praise. You know, God does not have an ego, and God does not want anything, actually. But God doesn't even know what wanting is. God doesn't know what getting is. And the condition of human beings are, we're born with an ego, born of an ego, projected. People are peopled from the ego. The ego peopled the world. The ego put the people out there. These 7 billion little bottom feeders wanting to get, psychologically, physically, get. And the ones that are called the successful ones are the ones that are the better getters. That's a pretty sneaky trap. The ones that get more are admired. And yet they have nothing to do with God, because God is not a creator of getting. In fact, Jesus teaches us that just like the Bible said, as you sow, so shall you reap, and we've heard that what goes around comes around, what Jesus teaches us is giving and receiving are the same. So all that I give is given to myself. That's why I need to be a giver, because I won't know my true identity, because I won't receive the love that I'm giving unless I learn to give the love.